Good afternoon. Here we discussed a new topic called conformal mapping. Conformal mappings are those mappings that preserve angles except at critical points, and these mappings are defined by analytic functions. In detail, we can discuss the following figure. Let C1 and C2 are two curves which is intersect at a point Z0 in Z plane. Let alpha be the angle between these two angles, the angle between the tangents. Then W is equal to f of Z is a function, and the image of C1 and C2 are C1 star and C2 star. Then the point Z0 is mapped to f of Z0. Here, under this mapping, the orientations C1 is here, then there is C1, the orientation, and C2 is here, and the C2 is here. The orientations are preserved. Also, the angles are same. Here it is, the angle is alpha. Here the angle is alpha. Under this transformation, the angle between C1 and C2 and C1 star and C2 star are preserved. This type of mappings are called conformal mapping. The mapping W is equal to f of Z by an analytic function f is conformal except at critical point. That is, the point at which the derivative f dash is zero. The derivative is equal to zero at a particular point, then that point is called critical point. The mapping W is equal to f of Z by an analytic function f is conformal. That means analytic implies conformality. Discuss the conformality of f of Z equal to Z square. Here, f of Z equal to Z square has a critical point at Z equal to 0. That is, its derivative is equal to f dash Z 2Z. That is equal to 0 implies Z equal to 0. 2Z equal to 0. That is, it is not conformal at Z equal to 0. Here, the conformality of Z square we discussed. W is equal to Z square. Then W is represented as a UV plane. Therefore, it is U plus IV. That is equal to X plus IY the whole square. Using the identity A plus B the whole square, if we expand, it is written as X squared minus Y square plus I into 2XY. Therefore, the real part U is equal to X squared minus Y squared, and V is equal to 2XY. Then, here we consider four cases. That means, image of some curves under the transformation W is equal to Z squared. First, we consider the image of real axis, that is Y is equal to 0 on Z plane under W is equal to Z square. Image of real axis Y is equal to 0 in the Z plane under W is equal to Z square is, the real axis Y is equal to 0, therefore U become X square and V is equal to 0. That is, U is a positive X square and V is equal to 0. That is, the imaginary part in the UV plane is 0, which is a positive real axis in the W plane. That is, under the transformation W is equal to Z square, the point on the real axis of Z planes are mapped into positive real axis of W plane. Image of the imaginary axis X equal to 0 in the Z plane, W is equal to Z square. That is, image of imaginary axis, that is the real part X equal to 0. X equal to 0 implies U is equal to minus Y square and V should be 0, which is the negative real axis in the W plane. Under the transformation, W is equal to Z square. Next, image of the line X equal to C parallel to the imaginary axis of Z plane under W is equal to Z square. That is, we consider the line X equal to C in X equal to C, which is parallel to the imaginary axis in Z plane. Therefore, U is equal to, substitute X equal to C, C square minus Y square, V is equal to 2CY. Instead of X, we substitute C. then find out the value of eliminating y. Therefore, we find out the value of y. Y is equal to v by 2c. Then substituting it is in the value of u, that is u is equal to c square minus v square by 4c square. Rearranging and take LCM, v square is equal to 4c square of u minus c square, the variable v square and u, which is a parabola. The standard equation of parabola is y square is equal to 4ax. One is in the first degree, second degree here. That is v square is equal to minus 4c square into u minus c square, which is a parabola whose vertex is at c square and 0. Then the case 4 and the final case. The case 4, image of lines y is equal to c parallel to the real axis of z plane under w is equal to z square. That means we have to find the image of y is equal to c under the transformation w is equal to z square. That is y is equal to c, we substitute in value of u and v. We got it is u is equal to x square minus c square and v is equal to 2cx. Therefore, x equal to v by 2c. Eliminating x, that implies u is equal to c square minus v square by 4c square. Then v square is equal to, rearranging this one, 4c square into u plus c square, which is a parabola whose vertex is at minus c square 0. Example 19, discuss the transformation w is equal to e raised to z. Here w is equal to e raised to z, that can be written as u plus iv is equal to e power x plus iy. Applying the properties e raised to x into e raised to iy, then e raised to x into e raised to iy can be written as cos y plus I sin y. Then u is equal to e raised to x into cos v and v is equal to e raised to x into sin y. Then in these cases, we have to find out the image of real axis y is equal to 0 in the z plane, w is equal to e raised to z. Here y is equal to 0. Substitute y is equal to 0, u is equal to e raised to x and v is equal to e raised to x into e raised to 0 into e raised to x into sin 0, 0. Therefore, v is equal to 0, which is a positive real axis in the w plane. That is, under the transformation w is equal to e raised to z, the points on the real axis of z planes are mapped into positive real axis of w plane. Then we have to find out the image of imaginary axis at x equal to 0 in the z plane under w is equal to e raised to z. Image of imaginary axis x equal to 0 in the z plane under w is equal to z. We substitute x equal to 0 in the value of u and v, we got u is equal to cos v, cos y, and v is equal to sin y. Then squaring and adding, u square plus v square is equal to 1, which is a unit circle in the w plane. This is under the transformation w is equal to e raised to z, the points on the imaginary axis of z planes are mapped into unit circle of w plane. Then we have to discuss the case 3, image of lines x equal to c parallel to the imaginary axis of z plane under w is equal to e raised to z. Here we consider x equal to c, then u is equal to e raised to c cos y and v is equal to e raised to c sin y. Then find out the value of cos y and sin y from each expression. Then we know cos square y plus sin square y is equal to 1. Substitute these values, u square by e raised to c the whole square plus v square by e raised to c the whole square equal to 1, which implies u square plus v square is equal to e raised to c the whole square, which is a circle with the center at origin and radius e raised to c. Image of the line y is equal to c parallel to the real axis of z plane under w is equal to e raised to z. Substitute y is equal to c in the value of u and v, we got cos c and sin c. Then you find out tan c is equal to u by v, there v is equal to u tan c, which is a straight line passing through the origin. Next heading, linear fractional transformation or Mobius transformation. A transformation w is equal to az plus b divided by cz plus d, where a, b, c and d are constants, and where ad minus bc not equal to 0 is called linear. Where ad minus bc not equal to 0 is called linear fractional transformation. Note that we find out the derivative dw with respect to z, that is ad minus bc divided by cz plus d the whole square, applying quotient rule. Then ad minus B is not equal to 0 implies the conformality for all Z. That means the condition for the conformal mapping is the derivative